In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to set up and operate the ECMO simulator. It consists of two cases. The small one is the pump case. The bigger one is the body case. There are clear tubes that connect the two cases. Outlet A is connected to outlet A, B to B, C to C, and D to D. Connect the ECMO trainer to a power outlet. Make sure to choose a socket with grounding. The protection switch will blink green if grounding is detected. If not, it will blink red. Switch on the protection switch by pressing a couple of seconds. Now, open the pump case to fill the blood tank. Make sure to fill it with distilled water. You may add hygienic solutions or color to the water. That's up to your preference. Fill the tank completely. Then press the filling button to pump water into the two pumps. Switch on the pumps. Start both pumps in mode 0. The tubes will transport all air inside them to the tank until all air is out of the system. Now the system is ready to use. The pumps have a big knob to adjust the volume of blood that is pumped. The display of the venous pump can be adjusted. This pump is operated in mode 1, showing the blood volume in liters per minute. If you press the start button for more than 3 seconds during operation, a small asterisk sign will appear. This means the pump volume display can be adjusted now by turning the lower small knob on the left. Adjust the volume to the value you see in your ECMO machine or any other flow meter. The arterial pump is operated in mode 2, showing the speed of pulse. The display shows the seconds between pulses. The speed can be adjusted by turning the small knob on the upper left. 0.60 seconds will be equivalent to a pulse rate of 60 per minute. The speed of pulse and volume of blood can be adjusted during the training. All instruments like needles and guide wires can be used for simulations. Dilators can be used for correct procedure, but are not really necessary to dilate the pad. You can use all common cannulas just as in a real patient scenario. The full procedure can be trained, including connection and operation of an ECMO machine. After each puncture, the tube is pulled out and cut off to remove the big puncture hole that is produced during the training process. The tube can be pulled out about 10 times until it needs to be replaced. Remove tubes A and B from the pump case. Put one tube end in a bucket so that the water can flow out. Remove the other tube and connect the air pump. Pump air into the tube to remove all water and do the same procedure with circuits C and D. Connect one tube to outlet A of the pump case, put the other end in a bucket, switch on power and press the filling pump button to empty the tank completely. After the training, you should switch off the security switch.